I'd like to announce that final action may now be made regarding the appointment of an individual. The motion that I'd like to present is that we extend the current tax administrator's contract till December 31st. And that would be the contract for Gerald York, and continue as tax administrator for Alamance County. That's my motion.
Second.
Second. Is there any other discussion or questions? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed?
Nope.
Thank you.
No opinion.
Commissioner comments?
Yes, I do this with a heavy heart, but not. Most people probably don't believe it, but I do. I think sometimes we all don't want confrontations, or we try to avoid confrontations, and things shouldn't be viewed as a confrontation. When there's discussions that need to be held, meeting of the minds need to be had. It shouldn't be a negative. It shouldn't be a confrontation, and it should be a learning experience for everybody involved, including myself. Sort of give you a little history on what is making me do this tonight. At the last meeting, there was a comment made by our chair, Tom, with all due respect, when Terry Johnson made a reference that, you know, if you want to know something about the Sheriff's Department, you know, come see him. Come talk to him. And the reference was that we should do that. And you could either take it to be privately or at our table, but not in the press. And, you know, I sat down here and I heard that, and I kind of made a motion like, what did he say? And I wanted to respond then, and I didn't. And I wanted to respond in this section here that we're in tonight right now. And I thought, no, I've had enough, and everybody's had enough. Let's go home. So I was going to let it slide. And I know there's an image out there of me going to the press and talking to the paper. I'll assure you, I'm not a deep throat of Watergate fame, but I have no qualms about dealing with the press. My obligation is to the constituents that are out there, the taxpayers of this county. I respect this board wholeheartedly, but I don't think I do anything that's insubordinate by talking to the press. I can assure you the article that we're referencing, that was being referenced that night, maybe, you know, indirect, was the article that was in the Alamance News, and I don't hesitate at all what that article was about. I had asked questions for literally months about jail population, bed space, rental fees. I've asked for months what was the bed count on ICE versus the detainees and so forth. I mean, the Marshals program. So, you know, sometimes the best course for me to take is to do just what I do, or I wouldn't have done it. Yes, I do call the paper a lot, and I'm not ashamed of it. I call the local radio show, and I'm not ashamed of it. That's the way I am. I believe in speaking out, and I don't like to play a certain way to please people. I just have to get my case out there, let the public push the debate. And sometimes I think maybe there's an effort not to allow the public to push the debate. But with that said, you know, this past week I heard somebody ask the question about why was our agenda not on the why was our agenda not on the internet? And I didn't pay much attention to it. I mean, I don't have internet, I don't have a computer, so I didn't look to see if it was on there. Couldn't have. You know, I didn't make an inquiry. But I thought, well, yeah, I'm going to check it out because it piqued my interest. So I called county manager, and I asked Craig, I said, why is the agenda not on the internet? And I'm going to give the verbatim response as I heard it. And that verbatim response was that the chairman wanted to hold it as long as possible. And didn't give me a reason, whether it be, I understand the reasons now, the reason now being given is that it was LME it was a timing issue and so forth and so on. But I thought, well, and the next logical question would be, are you talking about just that meeting, or are you talking about all of them? The direct response back to me was all of them. And that was verbatim. And I said, I asked the question, well, why? And the direct response back to me was policy. The word policy was used. And that's, in my mind, now that I'm hearing that the LME part is being thrown in, that's, I don't believe you'd have policy just for that, number one. Number two, one versus all is two different things. And then I said, well, why? Once again. And Craig went on to say, well, and no offense, but in my opinion, all your replies were kind of tentative. Like, I really don't want to tell you this, but you're asking, so I got to tell you. And I respect you being honest about it. But that's what you said to me. And I said, again, well, why? Beyond the question of you answering that it was policy. And you said, well, don't quote me on this, but. And then I stopped you. And I said, I don't want to hear it. I know why. I believe I know why. So you never did say what you didn't want me to quote you. That doesn't sit well with me. None of it. Now, if there's a difference in how you're believing that you talked to me, I want to hear it. I haven't talked to Tom. No offense. Tom did call me twice. I didn't return the calls because I just didn't feel like talking about it except in this setting here. I don't lobby very well. I'm not saying that he would have lobbied me, but I don't lobby very well. I do my own homework and my own research, and I do what I do. This country, and probably mankind's furtherance of progressive, you know, advancing mankind's position worldwide, goes back clearly, probably the biggest thing you can credit our advancement is a press. A Gutenberg press was discovered in mid-1400s. In Beijing, China, people started writing on silk to produce some type of writing, some type of report to the people, or that the people could get. And you bring it on up to our country. You know, you had Paine do the... I knew I'd forget to... What'd Paine do? Common Sense pamphlet. You had the Federalist Papers being published in New York newspapers. You know, our country is built on freedom of the press. You know, for me to see any attempt to keep the press away from what the operations of government are just fly all over me. And that's why I have to speak out. You know, I'm getting the idea from what the gist of the phone call that Hale created, and I'll just leave it at that, that there was an attempt to delay giving information to the press that, yes, we might not have to give it to them legally, but ethically and morally, we should. As soon as that agenda is ready, that agenda should go to the press. If you know, we have a reason not to give it to them at all, period. But, you know, I just think it, you know, I understand that the chairman has a prerogative to do certain things as chair. I question possibly what those prerogatives are, whether they're legal or whether they're mandated or whether they're self-assumed by one or two or more. I just have serious issues with what the conversation I had with Craig. And when I link that with the previous comment about we shouldn't have dealt with the press on a particular issue, and I combined two of them in less than 2 weeks, yes, I've got a concern as to how all that came down. So if anybody wants to correct anything that I've heard from Craig, now I haven't talked to Tom, so, and I understand Tom's got an explanation, and I'd like to hear it if he feels like, you know, talking about it. But again, the all the explanations I've heard outside of this room is that it was for one meeting, and it was due to LME. I could have bought that. But Craig's comment to me, all the meetings, policy, and that it was a policy new policy going forward, and that the innuendo clearly was something other than what should have easily been quoted in a manner of, well, don't quote me on this, but, you know, that's not the way we need to be doing county business, in my opinion. That's not the way I would do it. I don't have anything to hide, and I don't, I'm not scared of the press inquiring about anything we do at any point in time. And if somebody's worried that there's something on our agenda that's going to generate a newspaper calling and getting an article going about it, I think that's what ought to take place, as long as it's the truth. And that's all I care about. So, you know, tonight we have a truth factor here of what actually took place. I've told you my involvement with it, and I haven't stretched it at all. So if anybody's got, you know, a comment they can make that proves me wrong or corrects what Craig said, or for somebody to admit that it was misunderstanding on Craig's part to have that interpretation that he told me versus what I hear that Tom's saying about it, let's hear it. I think we're big boys and girls, and we ought to be able to talk about it without feeling like we're trying to kill each other. I'm not trying to hurt Tom. I'm not trying to hurt Craig. But I didn't like those replies.
Thank you, Tim. Are there other comments?
I don't know if there is a policy to the agenda coming out. Is there a policy? I guess that's my question, because the last meeting we got it too early, I thought, and there was an issue that was brought up that needed to be on there. So you could have addressed the sheriff in agenda, which never got addressed, really. So is there a policy?
There's a standard that we've operated on ever since I've been here, is that we try to have the agenda set by 12 o'clock on Wednesdays, and that we also try to get all the information and backup documents from department heads at that time. And then we send that information to the chair, and then we'll have the chair review, and then we review that, and then we try to get out the agendas on Thursdays. Sometimes that doesn't happen.
Right.
Sometimes there's issues that come up. Again, with respect to the issue being late last week or late this week, was because Tom had a conversation with me that he was concerned that the agenda was getting out too early and we were going to have the LME dissolution on, which the board agreed to put on this agenda. But we weren't ready for it because it's going to be in a couple of weeks. We had a meeting late on Thursday afternoon, so we couldn't get it out on Thursdays.
So that really isn't a stated.
There really has been statement of practices. Okay. It's been the exception, not the rules kind of being getting it out on Thursdays, but there have been exceptions getting it out early and late.
That was my only question about it, because I wasn't really sure. And, you know, Friday's fine with me to get it on Friday, because that gives me the weekend to look at it. You know, I wouldn't want to wait till Monday to get it to have to look at it.
Yeah, that would be a problem.
Any other comments?
Well, I'd like to ask another question. Your comments to me were clearly in the tone of something, in my opinion, that wasn't very positive. In my opinion, your tone to me was the chairman wants to hold the agenda as long as possible on all meetings. Now, that's what you told me in just a handful of words. How can that be deciphered as it's just for normal tactical reasons, normal daily good business practices? I mean, that just doesn't jive with me. I mean, do you want me to believe, no offense, but I'm going to ask you point blank, do you not feel like you were saying that the chairman wants to hold as long as possible for all the meetings, and that I probably wasn't going to like to hear that?
The chairman, and again, I'm not speaking for the chairman, I believe he had a concern, and I actually got fussed at because we had the LME dissolution on the last meeting and we weren't ready for it.
What about all the meetings? I don't go Because I made a point to ask you about all the meetings, and you said yes.
There was, he wanted to know if that could be moved forward to make sure that we had all of our agenda items ready, so we were not rushing things, if there was a possibility to do it on Fridays, and we said we could do whatever.
Was there ever any discussion about whether or not there was a concern about whether the press would get a hold of stuff too early and do articles on them? Was that ever?
I mean, if it comes out Friday.
There was a concern about the press getting the agendas before the board did.
I'm not beat it to death. I know what I believe, and I'm wrong, I'm wrong. God will forgive me if I ask for forgiveness, but I think I have my ideas. So.
Thank you, Tim. Any other comments?
No.
Well, do we have any announcements?
What are we going to do with the agenda? Let's go back on what is the policy going to be on the agenda? You cut the agenda off at what time?
Wednesdays at 12.
At 12. All right. Now, who's going to get the agenda after that?
We usually send that to the chair for his approval.
Who puts it on the internet?
Tori does.
Tori.
But it doesn't go on there then, does it? I mean, it doesn't go on there on Wednesdays.
No, usually on Thursdays.
Thank you, Tim. Any announcements? If not, stand adjourned.
Thank you for tuning in to the Alamance County Commissioners meeting. Meetings of the Commissioners Board occur at 7 p.m. on the first and third Monday of each month in the Commissioners' Chambers on the second floor of the County Office Building located at 124 West Elm Street in Graham. Changes to the meeting schedule will be posted on the Commissioners' website at www.alamance-nc.com. You can watch the most recent meeting of the County Commissioners on the second and fourth Wednesday of each month on Time Warner's local public access channel beginning at 10 o'clock p.m. You can also watch recordings of the most recent meeting and past meetings by going to our website at www.alamance-nc.com. Please visit our website for more information on watching commissioner meetings online. For technical questions about this meeting's online or television broadcast, please contact our county webmaster at webmaster@alamance-nc.com. Please note that this address is for technical questions only. Questions or comments regarding the content of commissioner meetings may be made to the commissioners themselves. You can find their contact information at the Alamance County website at www.alamance-nc.com. Click on the link that says Alamance County Commissioners to visit the Commissioners website, where you can learn about our Commissioners, read minutes of past meetings, access agendas, and find other information about our Board of Commissioners. You can also send mail correspondence to the County Commissioners by addressing it to the Alamance County Commissioners, 124 West Elm Street, Graham, North Carolina, 27253. Again, thank you for tuning in to the Alamance County Commissioners meeting.